says, and I will take you. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And we thank you, Jesus. And we thank you for another day, God. Oh, God, we just praise you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We just thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Another day. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God, you are worthy. God, we look to the hills which come of our help, God. All of our help, God, comes from you, God. God, we come tonight, God, to worship you, God, to glorify you. We welcome everybody tonight. Amen, amen. Tune in, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We apologize if I really technical difficulty. God, we thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, you are worthy. God, we thank you, Jesus. We thank God for everybody tuning in tonight. Amen. Amen. Call your friends. Call your neighbors. Amen. Start a watch party. Amen. Like, share, whatever you need to do. Amen. True Love Deliverance Midweek Boost Bible Study is on the air. Amen. We thank God for him. Amen. Open up a doorway. Amen. For us to still spread his word, even though in the midst of trial and tribulation, the word will still go forth, amen. And the word is going forth, amen. And we thank God for using us as vessels, amen, to spread his word, amen. How many of us know that we are here and we were created, amen, to do his will, amen. We are created to be his vessels, amen. Lord, we're going to rejoice and we're going to be glad in it, God. We just thank you, Jesus, for the victory, amen. How many of us have the victory, amen? How many of us have victory, amen? We may not have it in every area of our life, amen, but we have victory, amen, amen. The Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, amen. We may not see it, we may not feel it, amen. We may not even believe it, amen, but we gotta activate our faith, because our now faith, when it kicks in, amen, faith is the evidence of things not seen, amen. So we may not see it, amen, but we got to believe by faith that we have the victory, amen. I've got victory, amen. I've got victory, amen. I may not feel like it every day. I may not see it, but you know what? I believe it by faith, amen. The Bible said without faith, it's impossible. No matter how hard we try to fake it, no matter how much we try to make it, without faith, it is impossible to please God. The Bible says, he who cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them. Amen. We are the them that diligently seek him with all of our power, all of our might, with everything within inside of us. If we really, really put everything that we have into worshiping and seeking him, amen, we got to believe it, amen, amen, and it will happen, amen. So we thank God for tonight, amen. We thank God for tuning in, amen. If we could, amen, for a few seconds, amen, just let God know how happy we are to be here, amen. Let's worship him, amen. God, we just thank you, God, for being sovereign, God. We thank you for being omnipotent, God. You are all-powerful, God. Oh, God, we thank you for being omniscient, God. You're here, there, and everywhere, God. God, we thank you right now, God. There's no lack in you, God. You are the source of our strength, God. So, God, you are our creator, God. We were created in your image and in your likeness, God. Everything we have, God, is because of you, God. God, we think about, God, we woke up this morning, God, that you had already commanded the birds to sing, God. You've already commanded, God, the sun to rise, God. You've already commanded, God, the waters to flow, God. Why? Because you had us in mind, God. That's why we worship you, God, because you always have us on your mind, God. God, let us return the same thing to you, God. Let us always have you on our mind, God. It's our desire, God, to please you, God. And God, sometimes we fall short, God. But God, you know right now, God, that we are limited, God. God, but you are unlimited, God. God, we are finite, God, but you are infinite, God. Oh, God, there's no lack to you, God. God, we just thank you, God. We thank you tonight, God. God, we pray tonight, God, you will speak a word, God, into the atmosphere, God, through this vessel tonight, God. I yield myself to you, God. Oh, God, I look for no gratitude, God. I look for no pat on the back, God. I look for no glory, God. I look for nothing more than you to get the glory, God, out of your word that's going to go forth on tonight, God. So, God, I lift up my hands to you, God. I tell you, thank you, God, for using me, God. Thank you for choosing me, God. Oh, God, I just give you glory and I give you honor, God. Bless your people on tonight, God. God, search our hearts right now, God. If there's anything in our hearts, God, that should not be, God, remove it right now, God. Create in us a clean heart, God, and renew the right spirit within us, God. Create in us a clean heart, God. Give us your spirit, God. Oh, God, said not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit, says the Lord. God, we thank for your spirit that's in this place tonight, God. How many of us feel his presence? Amen. The Bible says in his presence, the fullness of joy. You may have been burdened down today, but right now you should be in his presence and you should feel joy tonight. I've got joy deep down in my sanctified soul. I thank God for his grace and his mercy. Amen. So we thank God that we're going to go into God's word tonight. We give him glory. We give him honor. Amen. Tonight, we're going to look in the book of Romans. Amen. How many of us tune in to Minister Rosie Robinson on Sunday morning, who gave an awesome word from God? Amen. She was a willing vessel used by God, and she spoke on love. Amen. Love. Amen. Love covers a multitude. Amen. Love covers. When you don't even want to acknowledge it, love will cover it. Amen. When you don't want to face it, love will cover it. Amen. Amen. We just thank God for love. Amen. And we know that there's the love of God. Amen. That agape love. Amen. That real love. That God love. That God type of love. Amen. So tonight, let's look in the book of Romans. Amen. We're going to go ahead and get started. Amen. The book of Romans, the 12th chapter. Amen. We're going to look at verses 9 through 16. Romans 12th chapter. Verses 9 through 16, amen. But before we start, I'm going to look at something, amen. Let's go to the verse 1 and 2. Because it's always important that when we read the word of God, that we know how it relates to our life, and amen, and something that maybe we're going through, amen. And how many of us know the Bible says we should always sit in front of wise counsel, amen. Wise counsel will give you wise choices and wise words, amen. So tonight we're gonna look at Romans 12, and we see tonight that Paul is talking, and he is talking to believers. How do we know he's talking to believers? If you look at the first couple of words in there, and he says this, and so, dear brothers and sisters, he's talking about brothers and sisters in the gospel, amen. He said, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. Let him be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind he will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship him. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. He said, then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Amen. I want to stay right there for a few seconds before we get into the lesson. Amen. Paul gives us some words to grow by. Let me say that. While Paul gives us some words to grow by, Paul says, when you give your bodies to God, amen, I'm going to come back to that. He said, not because of what he's done, but because of all he's done. Amen. Anybody, don't just give your body to Christ because he saved you. Give your body to Christ because he saved you, because he keep you, because he's healing you, because he's delivering you, because he's setting you free, because he's doing everything for you, not just because of what he's done, but because of all he's done. That's what Paul says. Paul says, be a living and holy sacrifice. In other words, he said a living sacrifice. He talked about a sacrifice that's walking. A sacrifice that's talking, a sacrifice that's believing, amen. A sacrifice that can let people know about the goodness of God, amen. How many of them know back in the days, the sacrifices that they sacrificed, they killed those sacrifices. And those sacrifices only represented a peace offering to God for what we did. But how many of us know now that we are a living sacrifice? We're a living, breathing sacrifice, walking around and telling people about the goodness of God. So Paul says, when you give your bodies, he's talking about your body, when you give everything, not just your heart, God wants all of you, amen. Your mind, your hands, your feet, everything about you, God wants your bodies. He wants all of your body, amen. How many of you know that your body, your body can glorify God? You ever get in the presence of God, all of a sudden your hands just go up? Oh, your feet start to move, amen? Oh, all that. That's why he wants all of you. He don't just want your heart, amen. When people can't see your heart, they can see your hands, they can see your feet, they can see you glorifying God. So Paul says, when you give your bodies to God, he said, because of all that he's done. Just think about all the things he's done. Paul says, you're going to be a living and holy sacrifice. And this is the kicker right here. He said, the kind that God will find acceptable. Amen. That means God wants your whole body. He wants all of you. But when you give all of you to him, when God fixes the imperfections in you, when he creates and makes and molds you into what he wants you to be, amen, you become acceptable to him, amen. We're not talking about to the world, amen. The world take you as you are right now. But God wants to make you and he wants to mold you into something that he can use, amen. Look at something right quick. We're going to get into the lesson. Look at Malachi 1st chapter, verse 6 through 10. We talk about a sacrifice that's acceptable. Amen. A sacrifice that's acceptable. And the word sacrifice means to give. Amen. So a lot of times when we give, something, amen, how many of us know we want it to be good when we give it? Amen. How many of us want a bad present? We don't want a bad birthday present, a bad Christmas present, anniversary, whatever present. We want, somebody gives us something, we want it to be acceptable. Amen. We want it to be something that we can give. Amen. But in the book of Malachi, it says this. It says, a son honors his father and a servant his master. And God says this. He said, then if I am a father, he said, where's my honor? Amen. He's going to tell you what he's talking about. He says, and he said, if I am master, where's my respect? Says the Lord. He says, O priest who despise my name. He said, but you say, how have we despised your name? He said, you are presenting defiled food upon my altar. But you say, how have we defiled you? And that you say, the table of the Lord is to be despised. But when you present the blind for sacrifice, is it not evil? Amen. God says, when you give a sacrifice that you don't even want, amen. He said, that's not acceptable. That's not acceptable unto me. The people back then, they were given lambs with broken legs, wings with broken doves, and they were giving it to a God that they wanted to bless them. The sacrifice that they were giving was not acceptable, but they were giving it to him. Amen. But amen. But Paul says, when you give your bodies, make sure it's acceptable. Amen. So saints, we got to make sure that we clean ourselves up, amen. Our walk, our talk, our thinking, amen. Make sure that all of that is acceptable to him. I've told you many times, people are watching. Not only are the saints watching, remember back in the days, the older saints, they would watch you. If you did something, they would bring it to your attention. But the world is watching us. Check this out. The world is trying to find fault with the kingdom. Amen. The world is trying to find fault with the kingdom. Amen. Don't let the world find fault with you. Amen. So Paul says, he says, victory does not come by giving what you don't want. Victory comes by giving what's acceptable. Amen. So we can't just give anything and think that it's the right thing to give. Amen. We haven't gotten to the lesson yet, but I'm trying to get you ready for what Paul is going to talk to us about. Paul is letting us know that you got to be ready to give yourself. For us to receive, we got to be ready to give. Amen. Amen. And God only wants us to give him us. That's all he asks for is us. Amen. So I ask you this question. How many of us feel like we have victory? Amen. We may not have it in every area of our life, but we have victory in some things, don't we? Amen. We got victory over this flesh. Look, we don't go some of the places that we used to go. Amen. Can I talk to somebody tonight? We don't say some of the things we used to say. Amen. We don't hang out with some of the people that we used to hang out with. Amen. So we have victory over certain areas in our life. But how many of us know that we have not arrived? Amen. We still got some work to do. Amen. Somebody said work to do. Amen. So Paul says, you've got to give your body. You got to give all of you. Amen. So in verse 2, Romans 12, 2, Paul says, don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world. Amen. Isn't that amazing how Paul was talking back then about now? Because he knew that was going to be some things that was going to try to attach to us. Amen. Amen. Paul says, don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world. Amen. The word behavior means the way you act. Amen. We can't come into the house of God trying to get victory acting the way the world acts. Amen. We can't get victory by the way we control ourselves. Amen. If we control our way according to the world, amen, the way the world tells us to, amen, we'll never have the victory. Amen. Amen. So behavior is the way you act or the way you control yourself. How many of us know we can control this flesh? Amen. We can control this flesh. We can tell this flesh what we want it to do. Amen. 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 Behavior is always is also the way you allow yourself to act. Amen. Behavior is the way you allow yourself to act. Somebody cut you off in traffic. How do you act? Do you throw up fingers and point fingers and saying stuff out of your mouth? Amen. That's not pleasing to God. Amen. Paul says, don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world. Customs are habits or accepted practices. Amen. There are things that the world accepts. Amen. And we call it behavior. Amen. Or we call it the norm. Amen. That's just the normal way people do things. In other words, what we've done so long that it has become a habit. Those are customs. Paul said, don't copy, don't try to resemble, or don't try to look like the world. Paul is saying all of this to get us ready for this lesson tonight. Paul says, I want you to understand that if you're going to go before this altar of God, you have got to be a perfect sacrifice. You have got to be an acceptable sacrifice. Now, Paul says, since I've got that out of the way, Paul says in verse 2, he said, Paul said, let God transform you into a new person. In other words, take this old nature away from you and give you a new nature, a new heart, a new mindset, a new thinking, a new everything. Paul said, let God transform you. Transforming to take out and to put in. Amen. Paul said he's going to do all of this by the way you think. I'm going to challenge somebody tonight. Amen. Paul says, you will know or learn to know God's will for you He said, it's good and pleasing. When God transforms your mind, God will show you and God will speak to you and he will show you. This is the individual thing. He said, you will know or you will learn to know God's will for you. So now he's speaking individually. Amen. We're about to get ready to get into this lesson. This is an individual lesson. Amen. Though we are corporate, God wants to speak to your heart tonight. Amen. Paul said, then you will know God's will for you, either which is good and pleasing. Amen. So Paul says, God's plan for you is good, is pleasing, and is perfect. Amen. How many of us know that everything God does for us is good, is pleasing, and is perfect? How many of us say there are no flaws? No flaws. Amen. There are no regrets. Amen. How many of us can say this? What God's plan for my life is just what I need. Amen. 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 I mean, I know we can agree on that. God's plan for our life, God's plan for my life. Let me speak for Horace. God's plan for Horace's life is just what I need and what I needed. Amen. So God has an individual plan for each of us. Amen. So if we go to Jeremiah, remember Jeremiah said, God told Jeremiah, he said, yeah, Jeremiah, I know. This God speaking to Jeremiah. He said, I know the plans I have for you. Not for Israel. He said, I know the plans I have for you. He said, I have plans to prosper you. He said, I have plans not to harm you. He said, I have plans to give you hope and a future. Amen. So God is speaking to you tonight. Amen. God knows exactly what he has in store for you. Amen. Paul says in verse 3, he said, don't think because of you're giving yourself as a sacrifice to God, you have the victory. He said, you have to evaluate and measure yourself daily. Amen. Just because you have given yourself to Christ does not mean that you have the victory. You have to evaluate yourself every day, and you have to measure yourself every day. In other words, you got to say, God, did I mess up on something, God? I feel like I've fallen short somewhere, God. So you got to reevaluate that thing. Did I say something, God, that wasn't pleasing to you, God? Did I do something that wasn't pleasing to you, God? Did I measure up, God, to the standard that you set for me, God? How many of us know a lot of time we have to do that? But you got to do it by faith that the God has given you. Amen. It's okay to say, God, I messed up. God, I've fallen short, God. But it's okay to get back up again. Amen. Amen. So Paul says he has given you the faith that God has given you. God's given you faith for what? God has given you faith to do. Amen. God has given you faith to do. Amen. Amen. So now, Romans 12, 4. We're going to move on to this lesson tonight. We're going to see, do we really? Romans 12, 9 through 16. Romans 12, 9 through 16. Amen. Amen. Paul says our bodies, there are many parts to our bodies. And each part has a function. And he goes on to talk about how the church has many bodies, but there's one function to the church. And though our body has many parts, their function is to serve the body. And though the church has many members, the church is still one body, and the church body's function is to serve God. So in 12:9, Paul is going to challenge us tonight. He says this in Romans 12:9. Paul said, don't just pretend to love others. Paul says, really love them. And remember, Paul is talking to church people. Amen. It's so easy for us to love church people, ain't it? It's so easy for us to love to saints. because we're on one accord, amen. We're one body, amen. Paul said, but you need to hate what is wrong, but you need to hold tight to what is good. Now, Paul is going to dig deep into something. He's going to dig deep into your heart tonight, amen. He's already dug in there. You don't even know it yet. Paul, he's setting you up. Paul said, it's easy to love church members. It's easy to love the people that have the same agenda that we have, amen. Paul says, love each other with genuine affection. Amen. He's talking about that agape love, that God love. Amen. It's easy to do that. Amen. We're supposed to love each other with that God love. Amen. There's two kinds of love. There's many types, but the two kinds of love that the Bible really talks about is that agape love, which is that Christ-like love. But how many of us know that there's a filial love or a filial love, that it's just an ordinary love, amen? It's just an affection, amen? It doesn't have to be a sexual in nature, but it's just a love that we just have toward people or have toward things, amen? It's so much different than that agape love. Agape love is that love that only God can shed in our hearts, amen? So Paul says we need to love each other with genuine affection. Verse 10, Paul said, we need to love each other with genuine, with real affection, and take delight in honoring each other. Amen. So Paul, he's moving. He was talking about you, but now he's talking about others. Somebody say, it ain't about me, it's about somebody else. It ain't about me. It ain't about Pastor Howard. It's about you. Amen. So Paul says in verse 11, he said, never be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. In other words, Paul says, we got to work hard to please God, and we please God by what? When we please others. Amen. When we do right by other people, we are pleasing God. He said, we should work hard at it. Amen. You ever think about this? All the disciples, amen, all the prophets, amen, they didn't look for glory for themselves. Amen. They was trying to get us delivered. Amen. It wasn't about them. Amen. All the trial and turmoil, all the ridicule, the backlash, everything they went through, it was not about them. It was about us. They was trying to get us delivered. Amen. They were sending a word to us. So now Paul in verse 13, Paul says, when God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. Now, see, Paul is transitioning from individualism, amen, talking about us. Now he's talking about others. He said, when God's people are in need, amen. How many of us like to help God's people? I love to help God's people, amen. We can help them in so many ways. We're not talking about a financial. I'm talking about spiritually. Amen. Prayerfully, just loving on them. Amen. When they're going through something, just put an arm around them. Paul says, he talked about us first, pleasing God. Now he's talking about us serving others. Paul said, we got to be ready to help them, not yourself. Paul says, others. Be ready to help others. Amen. Quit depending on you all the time. No, it ain't all about you all the time. Amen. Paul said, first 14, he said, bless them who persecute you. All right, amen. Y'all see what Paul is doing? So what Paul has done is, Paul has went from being individual. He's talked about loving others. But now Paul is really testing you to see if you really do have the victory. Amen. We're going to see. Verse 14, Paul says, bless those who persecute you. Don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Paul said, do you have the victory when you can do this? It is so easy. Paul says, to bless the people of the church. It's so easy to love the people of the church. Because y'all guys, we got so much in common, amen. We reading the same word, amen. We serving the same God, amen. We believe in the same thing. We've got the same hope, amen. We're under the same grace, amen, the same mercy. But Paul says, you don't have the victory unless you can do this right here. He said, bless those that persecute you. How many of us think we have the victory, amen? It's so easy to have victory when we can do the easy stuff. But when you're on a battlefield and you ain't got the right instruments or you ain't got the right thing to go into warfare with, amen, do you still have the victory? Amen. This is what Paul is showing us right here. Paul says, bless those. Oh, my God. Paul said, you got to love those people that don't love you. Paul said, you can love the church people. You can love them. You can love on them. You can love on them. You can love on them. But you never have victory until you can love those who don't love you. The ones that talk about you. The ones that curse you. But Paul said, don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. My God. And we thought we had victory. Oh, I treat everybody nice. Oh, yeah, we treat the people in church nice. Oh, I treat everybody nice. I treat everybody nice in a job that treats me nice. But what about the ones that you go to work, they don't even speak to you? The ones that never have anything good to say about. What about your family members? Amen. The ones that never say anything good about. They always downing you. They never have anything good to say about you. Can you love them? I think the Bible says, bless those that willfully despise you. The ones that go out of their way to do wrong to you. Can you love them? Can you bless them? Can you speak a blessing into their lives? Paul said, bless those who persecute you. The ones that try to put you in chains, amen. The ones that say wrong against you to get other people to dislike you. Paul said, can you love them? Paul said, don't curse them. Paul said, pray for them. Oh, my God. Paul, you want me to do something that I just can't do. But go back to what Paul first said. You got to be a willing sacrifice, amen. To be acceptable to God, amen, you got to put up with some stuff. To be acceptable to him, Paul said, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. Paul said, you got to go through some stuff to know about the resurrection. Amen. You can't know anything about the resurrection until you know about the suffering. We got to go through some stuff. You just don't wake up in the morning and have victory. See, I'm challenging you today. You thought you had victory. Amen. But you ain't got victory until you can love those people that don't love you. I tell them a lot of times at work, that's one thing, one of my pet peeves. Don't let me walk you and face to face and see you. And I say, hey, how you doing? A good morning. And you walk past me. But I got the victory over that. You know what? Because I'm going to see you again. You know what? I'm going to speak to you again. But the world will tell you, despise them. Because they despise you. They didn't speak to you. Why you want to waste your breath speaking to them? Paul says, don't hate them. Paul said, hate was wrong. See, it's the spirit right there. Hate the spirit, not the man. Paul said, hate what is wrong, but hold tightly to what is good. What's your profession of faith? God, for you I live. God, for you I die. Paul said, that I may know him. Paul said, I got to go through some stuff. People going to throw stones at me, but I'm going to love them. They're going to curse at me, but I'm going to love them. They're not going to stand up for me when they know I'm right, but I'm going to love them. Amen? Amen. So when you go to work or when you, with somebody in your family, y'all don't get along, amen? Think about Paul. Paul said in verse 9, don't just pretend to love. Paul said, really love them. You know what breaks down barriers? Love. Love will break down a barrier. Pass by somebody day after day and keep telling them, good morning, how you doing? Hey, man, how you doing? Hey, God bless you. After a while, you may get a head nod. You may get a hand. But eventually, that heart will start to soften. Why? Because you've blessed them. Paul says, don't pretend to love. He said, really love. Don't pretend to love. Really love. Love each other with genuine affection and take delight in honoring each other. Amen? We're talking about those that we don't like. Love each other with genuine affection and take delight and honor each other. Never be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord. Amen. We got to work hard. Amen. Sometimes people don't want, we try to love them, but they don't want to let us love, but we got to work hard at it. Amen. Love don't give up. What we say, son, is love is long suffering. We give up so easy, but love suffers long, amen. Love will go through something, amen. So Paul says, don't just pretend to love others. Love each other with genuine affection. He said, don't be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. Paul, so he's transitioned. Now he's got us wanting to love those that don't love us, amen. Paul said, I'm trying to get you to the place of victory, but I got to show you that you don't have victory just because you love those that want to love you. You have victory when you can love those that don't want your love. Paul said, don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Amen. So Paul is transitioning again. He goes from individual self. He goes to others. And now he's going to, take this word out right here. He's going to the enemy. Amen. It's so easy to love yourself. Amen. It's so easy to love others. But now Paul wants you to love the enemy. Paul said, bless your enemy. Don't give them a piece of your mind. Give them God's blessings. Look at verse 15 through 16. We almost finished. Amen. We're not going to be here long. Amen. Paul said, be happy with those who are happy and weep with those who weep. Amen. Who do you think Paul is talking about? Ask yourself, who is Paul talking about? Paul said, live in harmony with each other. Don't be too proud to enjoy the company of ordinary people and don't think you know it all. Paul says, people we love are easy to love. But we have the victory when we can love, as Paul calls them, the persecutors. We got victory when we can love the persecutors. And when we are able, as he says in verse 16, to live in harmony with each other. We can live in harmony with the ones that persecute us. You know, that's one thing that we have to understand, that when people know that we are children of God, they may not treat us the way we want them to treat us. But they treat us according to the way that they know. They don't know the love of God. It has not been shed abroad in their heart like it's been shed abroad in our heart. But the more we chisel away at them, Paul said, you got to love those that persecute. There's a covering on their heart that they don't even know is there. Thank you, Holy Ghost. There's a covering that's covering their heart that that love can't break through that. But it's trying to break through. But the more we love on them, the more we break down that covering that's covering their heart. Paul said, we got to willfully love them with all of our might. And it goes back to verse 1 and 2. Paul says, when you give yourself as a sacrifice, God equips you with what we call love. And I like how Paul took it from loving yourself to loving those believers to even loving your enemy. That's how we know we got the victory. When we can love our enemy. Paul says we can live in harmony with each other. Harmony is nothing more than love. Amen. When we can live in harmony with our enemy, that's real love right there. Because eventually the love is going to break down their stony heart. And God says he will give them a heart of flesh. He says he will remove the heart of stone. The same way he did you. Paul says, brothers and sisters, he was talking to us the way we are now. But our job is to keep loving our enemy so that they can become like we are. Amen? Paul says the ordinary people, the lowly people, the ones that don't know that they need God's love. It's our job to show them. But the only way we can show them is, go back to verse 1 and 2, we have to be an acceptable sacrifice. We can't be like in Malachi. We can't just give God anything and expect to have the victory. We will only have the victory when we give him our bodies. Amen. 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 So, in the end, do you really have the victory? I'm going to challenge not you. I'm going to challenge your heart today. Let the love that's in your heart radiate out to somebody that you know that don't like you. I can feel it right now. I don't know if I can do that. If you have become a willing and acceptable sacrifice, pleasing unto him, amen, and you want to please him, amen, what's our job? To win the lost to Christ. Amen. That's our job. So I'm challenging your heart, not you, because this flesh right here, this flesh do whatever. Amen. I'm going to challenge your heart. If you got love in your heart, amen, go to somebody tonight, tomorrow, this next week, next month. Amen. Go to somebody that you know that has persecuted you in the past and that you don't even want to deal with. I'm not going to deal with them. I know what they did to me. They kept me from a promotion. They kept me from getting a raise. They kept me from this, they kept me from that. Let your heart, not your flesh, go to them. Watch your heart break down the barriers that's surrounding their hearts. Go to them. I've seen it work before. Amen. I've done it. Amen. I used to come home grieved because of somebody that I consider my friend, and every time I saw them, they go the other way. But I refuse to let my heart harden the way theirs was. Why? Because I was a sacrifice. I gave my whole body to God, and he accepted. But when I allowed my heart, every time I saw them, if they went to the right, I go to the right. They went to the left, I went to the left. Amen. I made it my point to speak to them, even if they didn't speak back. But eventually, their heart, the shell that was covering their heart broke. So I challenge you. You can live in harmony with the ones that persecute you because you are a willing sacrifice and you've been accepted by God. Amen? Amen. So do you really have the victory? Do you really have the victory? And this is just what Paul says, and he's talking about loving the enemy. Do you have the victory against alcohol? Do you have it against tobacco? Pornography? It could be anything. Do you have the victory over those things? If we say that our bodies, or we've given all of us to God, we should want nothing more than the best, amen. So you tell that alcohol, I'm not going to drink you anymore. You tell those cigarettes, I'm going to put you down. You tell that pornography, I'm not going to look at you anymore. Because I have the victory, amen. Amen. Father, we thank you tonight, God. We come before you, God, believing and receiving victory tonight, God. God, not just victory, God, for those that persecute us, God, but God, against those things that are holding us back, God. We've declared and decreed, God, that we are sacrifices unto you, God, and that they're holy and acceptable, God. But God, there's something that's holding us back, God. So God, if we want the victory, God, we got to give everything, God. You say we've got to work hard at it. We've got to work, God, to confess you as Savior, God. But, oh, God, it's the Lord part that we have problems with, God. Oh God, when we confess you as Lord, God, that means that we are slaves to you, God, that you have total control over us, God. So tonight, God, somebody open your mouth and confess him as Lord. There's no one above him. There's no name greater than him. So if you repeat after me, God, I've fallen short, I've messed up, God. I've done things, I've said things that I shouldn't have, God. But tonight, God, I confess you as Lord. I confess you as my Lord and Savior, God. I confess out of my mouth, God. But God, I also believe in my heart, God, that your Father, God, that loved the world so much that he gave you on the third day, God. He rose you from the dead, God. And God, your word says you rose with all power and authority, not only in heaven, but on earth, God. So you have the power, God, and the authority, God, to save me, God. So God, I thank you for salvation, God. I receive salvation tonight, God. But God, tonight we also thank you, God, that you can restore, God. God, the word restore means to put back in place, to give back. Because God, right now, God, give back that heart that fell away from him. Tonight, God, we pray for restoration. If you want God to restore you, open your mouth and repeat after me, God, I know you as Lord and Savior, God. But I fell astray, God. I fell aside, God. I fell, God, pray to the enemy, God. But God, I want to come back home, God. I know you'll welcome me with open arms, God. And I feel your love right now, God. I feel that agape love. No longer will I do what I want to do, God. But I will do what you tell me to. So God, I thank you for restoring me, God. And I give you glory and I give you honor. So Father, tonight, God, we thank you for salvation. And God, we thank you for restoration, God. Cover those that have been saved and cover those that have been restored, God. Cover them in your blood and camp your angels around about them, God. And God, we give you glory and we give you honor. And we thank you, Jesus. It's in your mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Remember, I challenge your heart, not you. Amen, amen. Whatever is persecuting you, whatever is coming against you, whether it's a person, a situation, a circumstance, amen, let the love of God that's been shed abroad in your heart, remember, you're a perfect sacrifice, amen. You're not like the sacrifice in Malachi, amen. You're a perfect sacrifice. You're acceptable unto him. Amen. 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 We thank God for you tuning in tonight. Amen. For this midweek boost. Amen. We thank God for you tuning in, not just on Wednesday, but on Sunday morning. Amen. We see your comments. Amen. We see the love that you've been pouring out. Amen. Amen. I want to let you know that we give that love back to you. Amen. And we don't take it lightly. Amen. But we also thank you for sowing into the kingdom of God by way of True Love Deliverance Church. Amen. We thank you for the seed that you've been sowing. Amen. The Bible says he gives seed to the sower. Amen. Amen. So we thank God that if you want to sow into the kingdom by way of True Love Deliverance Church, amen, you can text the word give, G-I-V-E, to the number 855-773-6297. Amen. One more time, text the word give, G-I-V-E, to 855-773-6297. Amen. And I promise you, you are sowing into fertile ground. Amen. And we thank you, amen. As always, if we can be a help to you, amen, don't hesitate to call us, amen, because we have love, and that's in our name. True love delivers, amen. Let us pray, amen. One more announcement, two more announcements, amen. July 17th, amen, is our women's conference, amen, at True Love Deliverance Church, amen. If you have not already called, amen, call my wife, Minister Valerie Whitson, W-H-I-T-S-O-N, at the number 205-910-0021. Let them know that you want to attend, amen. We need a head count. Let them know how many people you're planning to attend with you, amen, so we can get a head count, amen. Because, amen, a lunch will be served, amen, and also the word of God will be served also, amen. Remember, this Sunday, amen, this is our fourth Sunday coming up. This is our youth Sunday, amen. If you've got young children, amen, bring them out this Sunday, 1520 18th Street North, Birmingham, Alabama, 35234. This is our youth Sunday, amen, and as always, we have a powerful word that's going to go forth on Sunday. Amen. Amen. 11 a.m. Amen. We'll see you there. Amen. Father, we thank you once again, God. Bless your people that have tuned in tonight, God. God, we thank you right now, God, for the challenge of the heart, God, and not of the flesh. God, we ask tonight, God, that we go right now, God, into the battlefield right now, God, with our weapons, God. Our weapons are not carnal, God, but they are mighty, God, in the pulling down of strongholds, God. So, God, we're going into battle right now, God, with our hearts right now, God. Our hearts are going to tear down, God, some situations and some circumstances, and, God, even some situations, God. And, God, we know right now, God, that you will get the victory, God, and the glory belongs to you, God. So, God, we just thank you right now, God. Cover your people in your blood, God, and camp your angels around about them. It's in your mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Won't you remember, God loves you and we do too. Amen. Be blessed. Amen. God, we thank you, Jesus.